Well, ladies and gentlemen, Mitchel Blake with FishIBX, and today I wanted to bring you guys a quick tip on how to clean trout. Today we kept a couple of trout while we were out fishing. Gonna eat them up tonight, so I'm gonna show you guys, like I say, what I do, and for this particular meal, I'm actually gonna do blackened trout. So I am gonna do scales off, skin off. I'm actually gonna just fillet the meat out. And that's one of the most important things of knowing how you're going to clean your fish to how you're going to prepare to cook it. A lot of times I'll put them on the grill and I'll just knock the scales off of them and fillet it out. But this time I'm going to fillet the meat as a whole from the trout itself. Okay. So here we go. Sharp fillet knife. This is a flexible blade on this knife. They make a ton of different kind of fillet knives. This is one of my favorites. Oldie Goldie, man, I've had this thing for a long time. But anyways, I'm not gonna mess with scaling these fish because like I say, I'm gonna knock the fillet out. What I'll do is cut down until I hit the backbone. I'm gonna make a turn and I'm gonna slice that right down toward the anal port. Just that easy. That's resting on that backbone. So I'm gonna turn my knife. Actually, before I do that, here's what I find an important step to do. Reach in and pull that sac out of that fish. If that stuff right there gets on your knife, it'll almost dull your knife for filleting these fish. So that sac is actually removed, and I'm just going to cut right down its backbone. The sharper your knife, the easier that is to do. And you can almost basically with a long knife and if it's extremely sharp, you can cut down that without any problem whatsoever and flip that over. And like I said, that knife, basically, I give it just a little angle and I'm sliding right down that backbone. Just that easy. And here, what I'm gonna do, being I want the skin off, I want the scales off, skin off, the whole nine yards, I'm gonna make just a slight push down till I hit the skin. I'm gonna turn that blade. And it's just, like I say, sharper your knife, the easier that is. And look, these fish were just caught and put on ice. They were put on an ice bath as soon as I caught them. So that fish goes, If you put him in what we call an ice bath with his basically my live wells plugged and I pack it full of ice and a little bit of water. So when that fish goes in, he firms up immediately. He's almost stiff. And right there you've got a clean fillet. And depending on who you have eating, my kids like to eat fish. They prefer if I cut the rib cages out, so I'll actually come in right here. And I'm gonna remove that rib cage here in just a second. If I was eating it just for myself, no kids involved, I'd actually leave that rib cage in. That is the piece inside of a spotted sea trout that I was talking about. If you remove it out, you can make these fillets just as pretty as they can be. If you leave that in and try to fillet it, your knife is gonna hit it. It for some reason, it doesn't like the cut that, I guess the membrane that's made of. Flay knife just doesn't agree with it. All right, I'm gonna flip it to the other side. Simple incision all the way down to the backbone. I'm gonna make a turn and I'm going right toward the anal port again. Just that easy. That's all the way to the backbone. Turn that knife. Sharper your knife, the easier that cut is. I'll flip that back. Once again, slice it down to the skin. And I'll work that meat right off. Just that easy. And that's a flayed fish right there. Skin's off, as you can see, most of that darker meat is right on the skin. Now you can shave that skin and that dark meat to come off on your fillet, but I don't really want that. So that's pretty doggone clean. It's just all in. Sharp knife is the ticket. That's gonna go in the scrap bucket. I'm gonna grab another one out here, out of the ice bag. Show you once again, I'm coming in behind that pectoral fin with an incision all the way down till I hit his backbone. I turn that knife, I go right for the anal port. Just that easy. As you can see, I open it right up. Take that membrane out right there. Swim bladder, some people call it. I don't know the exact scientific name for that. As you can see, it's full of air. I just popped it. If you take that out, that is the ticket for a clean, nice fillet. That knife is resting on that backbone. Keeping it resting right on that backbone and running right down. You flip that back. Down to the skin. Slight turn of the knife. Just like so. I'm leaving the majority of that dark meat right on that skin side. To the backbone. I'll flip that up. His guts are out, so I'm going right for that anal port again. If I were grilling these fish, I'd simply scale it and I would cut that fillet right off and I would put that flat side down, skin on, right on the grill. It's delicious. This is a delicious fish to eat. If you eat them fresh, oh my goodness, he's dynamite. Once again, complete fillet. You're not cutting in the guts, getting all that on your meat. Nice, pretty, little, clean fillet. Hardly any dark meat left on that whatsoever. Like I say, I'm gonna blacken these. I got some blackened seasoning. I'll get a skillet, put it on the grill, get it really, really hot, and throw it down. It'll almost like it's scorching it. Let it sit for a second, flip it over. Man, it's delicious. Do the redfish the same way. Look, I cut that trout down, hit his backbone. Simply turn my knife, pull it back. Right for the anal port. See how that opens up? You can open up that cage. You see that sac in there, how it's full of air? Air just released out of it. Now you can flay him. If you try to flay it with that in there, it's going to aggravate you a little bit. Some male fish. And if I weren't doing that on video, I'd take that knife and just, I mean, I would hit that with one, just about one lick, and it would cut that whole thing. So that's a flexible fillet knife. Looks like I set it against that and it has some bend to it. Flip it over to the backbone. Stand it up. Sharp fillet knives. That is a ticket. If you ever seen somebody clean fish and you're sitting there and you're amazed by it, like, daggone, how do they do that? How do they make that so clean? How do they make that so quick? It's just got a sharp knife. You try practicing this with a dull knife. It's gonna... it's gonna aggravate you. Now, if grandma saw me clean that fish and throw that rib, that little bit of rib cage out, she'd have a fit. Wash those up. And these fillets are ready for blackening. Fresh is the key. I don't freeze fish. I know some people do, but if you can eat him like that, he is so much better. Wow. And those are spotted sea trout fillets. We'll take it one step further. I'm going to show you how to remove the rib cage. If you prefer to, like I say, some folks want it removed, some folks don't want it removed. You can see on this fillet here, you can take your finger and press, and that rib cage kind of fold out. So I'll take that knife and come in right behind it. Some of them, I've seen some people grab that bone with the knife and they'll peel it right back. I'll take that and kind of poke it down. If your knife is touching a bone, then just back up a little bit and go right down it and get it where you can peel it back. And you'll peel those. You'll make that thing completely boneless. Few bones in that. There's a completely boneless fillet. Do that one the same way. Like I say, I've seen folks grab that with their finger and actually peel those bones right out. I'm probably not that good yet. And I usually hit it with the fillet knife, like I say. You're not bearing. The minute you feel that knife hit a bone, just back up just a hair. And you'll cut them right out and you'll leave the meat. Rib cage, perfect fillet, zero bones. And when you start removing the bones from it, folks eat it twice as hard. They eat it twice as hard, twice as fast. Man, these things are going to be good. Don't cut it down and lose all your meat. Check out the angle of that blade. Cut it with that rib contour so you can get it started. You'll feel it when it touches the bone. You cut those things right out and leave the meat. One little bone right there. I could probably pull it and pop it right out. On bigger fish, you may want a more stout blade. All depends on what kind of fish you're cleaning. I've got three or four fillet knives that I do different things with. But this one's by far for trout, for panfish, crappie. I use this knife a lot. Man, I've had it for a long time. And one of the things you can do, a lot of times I'll pop the tip on my knife just in case it slips off a fillet table or something and falls. I had one time that fell and stuck right through a boot. Since then, I'll pop the tips off a lot of my fillet knives. You'll see I'll pop the tips off just for that one incident. So that's a take-home message. If you got a fillet table that a knife might slip off of, you might want to cut the end off or grind the end off or pop the end off, whatever what you want to do there. It may save you from sticking yourself sometime. Anyway, hope you guys learned a little something. Maybe we'll do a video on these going in the frying pan for you. But stay tuned, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, check out some of our videos. Our plan on this is to show you how to catch them, how to prepare them, maybe how to cook them. And we'll enjoy the whole, every process. So see you guys. Stay safe. Good fishing.